It used to be a death sentence. Thanks to people like Mary Caffrey, HIV is now a chronic disease. Dreadful, but manageable. Caffrey is program coordinator of the Mother, Child, and Adolescent HIV program at UCSD.
When I came into this field in 1991, HIV was very different than it is now. We did not have the treatments. We did not have the strategies to care for people, to reduce transmission from mothers to children. We were struggling to keep people alive. Changes that have occurred, primarily in the mid to late 90s, in terms of being able to access an incredible group of medications, really brought the science to the people.
There were times when many of us involved in the program would be the only people outside of the individual patient to know about the person's HIV diagnosis. Mary has this ability to put people at ease, to make them comfortable, to establish a level of trust with them that makes them feel like it's okay to come into care.
I think one of the most exciting times happened in the early part of 1994 when we got the news that the first treatment that we could use during pregnancy to prevent transmission to children was effective.
Mary was the nurse that was responsible for recruiting the patients and monitoring their care while they were enrolled in the clinical trial.
And I remember getting the phone call, and I also remember calling the women that were still on the study here in San Diego and being able to inform them of that wonderful news that we had reduced transmission so much that we now had a standard, and that standard continues today.
The battle plans to fight HIV are forged in laboratories. The front lines are in the offices of people like Mary Caffrey.
Of course, the initial experience for our clients is not to believe it. And suddenly to come into an office and to face a healthcare provider talking to them about an illness that they now are going to have for the rest of their life is a big challenge. Yeah, I think many people, whether they be young men or young women, do not believe that HIV is going to touch them. And they make a lot of choices in their life with the idea that it's somewhere else. And I'm the reminder every day that it's in their lives. I get frustrated by the community's response to HIV, frankly. I am frustrated by the ignorance, by the apathy in the community, and I'm also very, very frustrated by the stigma that still exists because of the nature of this disease and how many people it's infected.
More than 10 years ago, Geneva was diagnosed with HIV. Today, she is the mother of two healthy children. To her, Mary Caffrey is more than a nurse. She is an angel.
Well, people were dropping off like flies when I heard about HIV, and I didn't do anything to straighten up my life because, why? I'm gonna be dead soon. But thanks to Mary and them in the clinic, I've been coming, and they let me know that because you're HIV positive doesn't mean that it's a death sentence for you. You know, you have to do your part, take your medicine, go to the doctor, get checked, make sure everything is in order, and you can live a healthy life. And here it is, 13 years later, second daughter later, you know, that I'm still around.
Eliminating the scourge of HIV and AIDS remains an enormous task. From her place on the front lines, Caffrey has seen the first positive steps toward that goal.
I know the numbers nowhere compete with what's going on in Africa, in Asia, throughout the world. Each year we serve anywhere from 25 to 40 pregnant women. And in the last 13 years, none of the women who have received their prenatal care services and their HIV services in our office have transmitted the virus to their infants. And the fact that at UCSD, through this program, we can touch so many people's lives and improve the quality of their life builds families and builds our community.